how pretty her eyes are.
Hmm. No, we'll keep that one. Yeah, he needs to chill out.
Jane's with him. You hear that?
She can't be that far. Two tomatoes.
That is a crazy looking bolete. It's like glimmering.
Ponsiris trifoliata. Check out these beautiful purple beans. I can't remember what they're called, but they are prolific right now. We sowed all these zucchini and beans back in, I believe it was late July, and now they are coming on really good. Drop some recipes for me.
Leo sucks.
I'm gonna keep that one there.
What do you need?
Nothing. I don't need your help.
I do it myself.
All right, y'all, while Taylor is over there doing the pawpaw bread recipe, I figured I'd show you these boletes before I cooked them up and ate them. I went foraging at my mom's yesterday, and I ended up not finding much, but I did find two old man of the woods. This is a type of bolete. We just tried it for the first time the other day, and it was very good. Like this one, we got two of these. And I'm pretty sure these are all the same. I think boletes are all the same species, but somehow they all look different. So I don't know, like, biologically what's going on here, but they're weird mushrooms. This, like a yellow bottom on this one with a pinkish orangish cap. This one has like it's just a beautiful, I don't even know what you would call that pattern, but a yellow bottom. None of these brews blue, by the way, so they might be edible. I'm about to check the rules here and see. Some nice reticulation on the stem. I don't think you can see that on this camera, but just another beautiful mushroom. We found one, you saw it earlier in the video, that had a red bottom. That was pretty cool. This one almost has a reddish bottom, like a reddish, orangish, pinkish with a brown cap. And this one I just found on the side of the road, and I'm not actually even going to try to eat this one because this was on the side of the road where they spray chemicals all the time. But it has a gray cap. This one has a gray cap with a red bottom, and it's not bruising blue, so it could be edible. But like I said, I'm just going to break this one into pieces and throw this one around the land, so hopefully we get some more of whatever it is. This is a really pretty one. It's like a turtle shell almost. Yeah, let me turn the camera around and let me show you all the rules that the person who taught me foraging mushrooms, it was a licensing class for the state of South Carolina, so I could sell it. You don't have to have a license to just forage it, but I tell people all the time, your first step with foraging, taking a class will work. But these are the rules that I go by, so I'm about to test them out. So pause on that if you need to. And I'm going to see these are any good. All right, none of these are bruising blue. Poor color, red, orange, not edible. That's rule number one. That looks like that's orange, so I'm gonna put it over here, and I'm not gonna eat that one. The old man of the woods, I know for sure I can eat these. Nothing else looks like these. So I'm not gonna run this test on. I'm not gonna run through these steps on the old man of the woods. I know they're good to eat. All right, not bruising blue is the second step. Third step, pores are white or pink, it's probably bitter. If pores are yellow, the taste will be sweet, nutty, or lemony. So let me see what this tastes like. And I'm not going to swallow this. I'm going to spit it out immediately. Not immediately. I'm going to get the taste first, and then I'll spit it out. Sweet and nutty. This bolete is edible. And let's try this one out. It's a little bit old, but I think it might still be good. We'll see. It might just taste bad because it's old. I don't know. That one's too old. I think this one actually might be an edible one, but like I said, it's too old. So I'm gonna add it to the stack, and I'm going to mix these in with some water, and I'm going to sporulate them, and I'm gonna spread them all over my property. So hopefully we get some more of whatever these varieties of boletes are. But we're gonna eat this one and these two old men of the woods. You hear that, T-Dog? We're gonna chow down. We'll have these for dinner.
Hot sauce
wasn't
even on the cabinets here.
You shouldn't be throwing hot sauce all over the place.
About a heavy metal
bad idea.
Probably let that cool a little longer. But we can give it a little tasty taste. Even though it's quite hot still.
I don't know if I'm focusing this thing. There we go, right there. Alright. Let us know.
Very rich pawpaw flavor. I like it. Maybe I'll put some milk.
Tasty?
Pretty tasty. I didn't use as much sugar as the recipe called for because I figured the pawpaws will make it plenty sweet, and I was right. So, very good.